All right, so today we're diving into something pretty fascinating, the intersection of AI and something that a lot of people see as pure luck, the lottery.
Yeah, absolutely.
And we found this story actually thanks to the podcast of Philippe, so thanks to them for kind of bringing this to light.
Yeah.
But we're going to be looking specifically how these three Italian students used AI to, to win the lottery not once but twice.
Yeah.
And we're going to talk about how he did it, what they did with their algorithm to make it work, and then also get an expert perspective, because obviously the lottery is a game of chance.
Right.
So is there something more to it? Can you actually use AI to predict these things? Should we all be running out and, buying lottery tickets based on algorithms?
Yeah.
So, stick with us and we'll kind of unpack all of that in this deep dive.
What's so interesting about this is that it starts with these mathematics students from the University of Salento in Lecce, Italy.
Okay.
And their initial motivation really wasn't about striking it rich or getting some, big payout. It was really just intellectual curiosity.
Yeah.
They were looking at number games, they were curious about trends, and they kind of just wanted to see what would happen.
Yeah, and it's funny because they called this a small experiment,
Yeah.
and I think for most of us, 4,500 euros is, a pretty good chunk of change.
Oh yeah, absolutely a good
I
outcome.
mean, that's not insignificant.
For sure.
So, I think, for them it was, maybe a small experiment, but the results were pretty tangible.
Definitely tangible, and that really fueled them to kind of go further and see, like, all right, if we can get this much with, this initial algorithm, let's really dive deep.
Yeah, okay, so walk me through that. How do they actually go about refining this algorithm? Like, what were they looking at specifically?
Well, they shifted towards looking at a much larger data set. So instead of just recent lottery draws, they actually went back and analyzed years of past results.
Wow.
And their goal there was to look for these recurring combinations, these subtle trends, anything that might not be obvious just by, looking at the last few draws.
So basically looking for, kind of these shadows in the random
Yeah,
then.
exactly. Yeah, trying to see if there's any order to the chaos.
Yeah.
And they also started focusing on specific types of numbers. So, for example, hot numbers, the ones that appear frequently, thinking those might have a higher probability of being drawn again. And conversely, they looked at the cold numbers, ones that haven't been drawn in a while, maybe thinking they're due for a comeback.
Okay, interesting. Yeah, and I feel like a lot of people do that just intuitively, when they're playing the lottery, but these guys took it to a whole other level, right?
Absolutely. And the big thing here is that they integrated machine learning.
Oh, okay.
And this is where, their algorithm starts to learn from this massive data set. And as it processes more information, it can actually start to identify, more complex and nuanced patterns than just a basic statistical analysis.
Right. Okay, so
Yeah.
it's dynamic, it's adapting as it's taking in all this information.
Exactly. It's becoming more sophisticated.
Okay, so they've refined this algorithm, they've, fed it all this historical data. They've really made it, super smart. And
Yeah.
then they decide, okay, let's try this again.
Yeah. And this time they upped the ante a bit. They invested 300 euros in a few specific number combinations that their algorithm had generated.
Wow.
And get this, they won over 43,000 euros.
Wow. Okay, so
Quite a jump from their initial winnings.
that's a huge jump.
Yeah.
That's yeah, that's definitely, going to turn some heads.
Yeah.
But at the end of the day, the lottery is chance, right? I mean, it's random. So this is where I think their professor Fabrizio Durante, his perspective is so interesting here.
Yeah, he's a professor of probability and mathematical statistics,
Right.
and he brings up this really important point, which is that every lottery draw is an independent event.
Right.
No matter how much you analyze past results, you
Yeah.
can't definitively say what's going to happen in the future. The underlying probability stays the same.
So essentially, even with their AI, even
Yeah.
with this incredible win, you could still say that a lot of it was just luck.
Yeah, I mean, from a purely statistical point of view, that's hard to argue with. But what's interesting is that while he very firmly believes in, the principles of probability, he also acknowledges that their method was really clever.
Yeah.
He sees the value in how they applied this data analysis to something that is, typically seen as completely random.
Right. So it's like they used AI to exploit those little, you know, wrinkles in the randomness.
Exactly.
Okay, so it sounds like the students themselves also recognized that this wasn't like a, you know, guaranteed golden ticket.
Oh, for sure. They knew that even with their, you know, sophisticated AI, there's no foolproof way to eliminate the random element of the lottery.
Right.
Their goal was to identify probabilities, not certainties.
Okay, so it's about tilting the odds, not completely controlling the outcome.
Exactly, yeah.
So really what we're seeing here is these Italian students used AI to analyze years of lottery data. They won twice, the second time winning a significant amount of money. But the expert in probability reminds us that chance is still a huge factor in the lottery. Past results can't predict the future. You know, this story really highlights how we want to find order and patterns even in things that are random. It makes you wonder what other systems that seem random might have hidden patterns. You know, maybe we can find them if we just analyze them carefully enough. If you enjoyed this deep dive and want to see more content like this, please help Le Podcast de Philippe reach 1,000 subscribers on YouTube today. We really appreciate your support.
Absolutely.
All right, until next time.
See you then.